The whole purpose of the cross isn't just that you're forgiven, but you become living, walking, breathing forgiveness. The whole purpose of the cross is Christ reproducing himself after his own kind. At one seed, dying, falling to the ground, springing up, much fruit after its own kind. Christians, little Christ-like ones, you are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. For he wouldn't have came. For he wouldn't have came. For he wouldn't have came. He thinks so. He thinks, look, would you buy an article of clothing for $50 if you didn't think it was worth $50? I mean, you might really want it bad enough and say, well, I don't think it's worth $50, but I want it, so you pay. So ultimately what you're saying is your desire to have that values at what you paid up for. So look what he paid for you. Paid for you. Paid for you. You're worth the blood of Jesus to God the Father. You're worth the blood of Jesus to God the Father. You're worth the blood of Jesus to God the Father. Not like close to worth it. You're totally worth it because he paid that. So you value it that, true? And you receiving that and accepting that and saying, whoa, is a real big deal. You cannot find the true value of your life through life. You can't find it through your family lineage, through your memories of childhood. You will not find the true value of your life except through the finished work of Christ Jesus. Except through the finished work of Christ Jesus. Except through the finished work of Christ Jesus. Except through the finished work of Christ. Christ crucified is the truth about you. Christ crucified is the truth about you. The truth about you. The truth about you. Period. 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 And if somebody in your life's not saying the same thing the cross is, it's because they're not seeing the same thing. Somebody's just treating you a little wrong or mishandling, why would you let that be the end of the world for you and identify yourself through that stuff? You have to see yourself through him. You have to see yourself through him. You have to see yourself through him. You have to see. That doesn't give you a permission to be this, that. It puts integrity, it puts discipline, it puts change in your life. It's not an easy out. It's actually the transformation of your life. That's why the biggest challenge, it's not an accident. The biggest challenge of the Christian is accepting this good news, period. To where it's a big deal and worth the time of their day and they stay excited about it, where they enter in long enough to where it becomes their joy, their joy, their joy, their joy. The biggest challenge, because the enemy knows that if the light ever comes on, the room's light. If the light ever comes on. He's so afraid. The enemy is so afraid that the light's going to come on. The enemy is so afraid that the light's going to come on. The enemy is so afraid that the light's going to come on. The enemy is so afraid that the light's going to come on. The enemy is so afraid that the light's going to come on. So he's trying to keep you from pursuing the light, seeking a million reasons why this can't work, or you can't seek God, or you can't be. It's all that frustration in the flesh, all that rationale, dime a dozen mentality. It's just nonstop with people because Satan is so afraid that the light's going to come on. Because if the light comes on, it's over, the room's light, it's over, the room's light, it's over, the room's light, it's over, the room's light. So if that's been your resume and your struggle, man, you ought to realize there is a spiritual strategy set against you to keep you from the very thing your heart's crying for. There is a spiritual strategy set against you to keep you from the very thing your heart's crying for. There is a spiritual strategy set against you to keep you from the very thing your heart's crying for. Trying to frustrate you, get you to whatever, what you really care about, and keep you from seeking, find, seeking, find, seeking, find. Come on, if he knew what he was doing, if the authorities of the earth ever knew what they were doing, they wouldn't have crucified the Son of God, but they did. So now they're playing the big cover-up. Come on, he is dead and raised to life. So he did what he came to do, and it is all fulfilled and accomplished, and the just live by faith. So Satan's trying to get us to live sensual, natural reality, human wisdom, and trying to cover up. He was played like a pawn by God, God's wisdom. He played the devil like a pawn right into his hand. He played on his instinct of steal, kill, destroy. Steal, kill, destroy. That's why Jesus said in the garden, do what you came for. It's the hour of darkness. What does that mean? It means God just drew back and let darkness do what it does. And he let darkness play right into the hand of his wisdom. So all we can do is steal, kill, destroy. Steal, kill, destroy. Kill, kill, kill. Lie. And God just pulls back and lets him. Played right into his hand and killed the Son of God. because now you just killed an innocent man and shed innocent blood, and now the guilty can go free. Because that blood goes to the mercy seat, there's mercy on the earth, and man's no longer held accountable for his sin, because one died, all can live. Because that's all he knows to do, killing. And he lets him die. Why? Because now he raises him to life, and through his life raised, we're justified, Romans 4 says. And then he didn't stop there. He took his blood into the throne room of heaven and applied his blood on the mercy seat, and then sat down on that seat, and forever, 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 forever represents man before God. So it broke the chains of death and judgment and the law of sin, and now the law of the Spirit of life through Christ makes us free. It's how it works. It's amazing. He raises him from the dead and trumps death forever. Now watch, he did that and went to the extreme of that, being beaten and battered and dying and pierced and hanging there, the extreme of it. Come on, it's extreme. He went to the extreme of that so he could put his spirit back inside of us so we could be what we were originally created to be. We've reduced it to a verbal prayer to get our name in a book. It's not what the gospel is. The gospel's not getting everybody to pray a prayer on the planet. It's getting our lives transformed so people see Christ in us. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. You are so worth the blood of Jesus to him. For he would be came. For he would be came. For he would be came. You're worth the blood of Jesus to God the Father. You're worth the blood of Jesus to God the Father. You're worth the blood of Jesus to God the Father. Christ crucified is the truth about you. The truth about you. The truth about you. Period. Period.